All right, so hey folks, thanks for joining us for another one of these little webinars we got going on. The cool thing about this one is we got invited to speak at this month's Adobe Illustrator LA user group. So we're going to do it online, and I'm over in Los Angeles. You could also hear Hanna. Hanna, you there?
Hello, everybody. Yes, I'm here. Nice. And so happy to invite Sebastian and Carlos to our Adobe Illustrator user group. I really wanted Carlos to come here to LA, but he didn't have time to do that. So I'm happy to see you all. And some of you, if you didn't make it today, you'll have a recording, and it's going to be an awesome, awesome, fun stuff. And we're going to keep it kind of not that formal so people can ask Q&A and everything. Also, I wanted to mention that in September, we're going to have another meeting about what's new in Adobe Illustrator and touch and mobile apps. And then in October, you can come see us at Adobe Max. I'm actually having a session on typography. Hopefully, you'll join me, and we'll keep you posted about some new stuff. Oh, I see Olivia here, and Kimberly is here, and Rossi is here. Wow, cool. Like to see some people that I know, and hi to everybody. And Sebastian, take it away, sweetie.
Well, we also had Mr. Carlos Garro on. I don't know if he still has his mic on. He's going to be helping us out over in the chat. So, Carlos, if you don't mind just saying hi to everybody really quick and a little introduction.
Hi, how are you?
Hey.
Hi, good night, everybody. Thank you for inviting me. It's a pleasure to be here. I want to join us some Sunday in person right there in L.A.
Yeah, it'd be fun.
For sure. Maybe next year.
Yeah. That'd be great because Carlos came down for...
Yes, we hope to see you very soon.
Yeah, he came down from Mac, so you know, me, Hanna, and Carlos in the same building. It was a lot of trouble going on that day, but a lot of fun.
It was really good. Yeah, I'm gonna miss you. I'm gonna miss you this year.
All right, cool. So what we'll do, you guys, is
good problems.
I know, right? Yeah, little troublemakers. A bunch of the Anchor Point Alliance over there in the corner. It was great. So, guys, really quick, what we're going to do today is we're going to talk about Astute Graphics. So what I'm going to do is go into the demo. After I finish off a section, then I'll invite Hanna and Carlos to turn their mics back on so they can let me know what's been going on in the chat. That'll be your guys' opportunity to let us know anything you guys want to know. Maybe if you guys got any feedback, we'd love to hear it. If you got any questions, now's the time to ask it, and I'll do my best to answer them all. All right, cool. So my name is Sebastian Bleek. I'm the graphic scientist, training and support lead over at Astute Graphics. Now, Astute Graphics, we make tools that plug right into Adobe Illustrator. So if you're already an Adobe Illustrator user, we got some tools to kind of help, you know, speed up your workflow and other tools that are just going to make it more fun to work with. Today, what we're going to be covering is the new website, which you guys should see on the screen already. If you guys do not see my browser right now, please let me know in the chat. And Carlos and Hanna, they'll turn on their mic and yell at me or something. After I cover the webinar, the website, I'll go into AutoSaviour, Phantasm, and then Collider Scribe. So we're going to try to get through all these guys within an hour. And after we finish each section, like I said, we'll bring Carlos and Hanna on so they could give us some feedback and let me know what's up in the chat. All right, cool. So this website right here.
Everything is okay.
Oh, we're looking good? Thank you.
Go ahead.
Appreciate it. All right. We got this new website up right here. It's been a long time in the making. I just hit refresh right now so I could bring it back up. So it looks really cool. One of the cool things about it is that you can actually see it a lot easier in a wider range of devices, which is really important nowadays, right? So it's a huge upgrade for us considering our previous, you know, if you guys knew what our last website looked like, you know what I'm talking about. Now, you see a couple of these different images kind of flashing around your screen a little bit. Now, all that is like you would normally see, that's our featured articles. So kind of just showing you guys what's hot over at astutegraphics.com. As usual, you'll see these little buttons down here at the bottom. Every time you click on these, it'll cycle through all the different articles. Just in case you missed one, this is a way for you to go back to it. Or over here on the right and left side of the screen, you got these little arrows that'll help you cycle through them as well. Now, one thing that I usually forget, depending on what my screen looks like, is that I could actually scroll down and start seeing some more info. And it looks pretty cool. As you go down, you start seeing some more information kind of just start populating in there. So here's some information on the bundles. We'll have some info on how to save time with our tools. Here's some information on some of our clients. And then once you start getting over here, check this out. We give you guys some sample, some example artwork made by a bunch of professionals that use our tools. Now, the really cool thing about this is you could actually download them, open them up in Illustrator, and break them apart. You get to see what's actually going on behind the curtain. And for me, that's one of the best ways for me to learn how to actually use these tools. I like to look over, you know, the shoulder of a professional or somebody else that's already working with the same tools. All you got to do is click on this big old link right here. It says download example artwork. The pack is 250 megabytes, so it's not that big, but it's got some awesome vector goodies in there. So as I scroll down, you're going to see this little form here. And this form, you're going to find it at the bottom of all the pages. The cool thing about this form is it's going to send a direct email to us over at astutegraphics.com anytime you need to get a hold of us. So that's why we got it at the bottom of all the pages. Excuse me. Here we go. We got the footer down here at the bottom. We got some cool info down here. I mean, along with all the social media stuff that you see down here way at the bottom right section. Over here, where it says like recent reviews and all that stuff, this is constantly changing. Just anytime we have some new features or something new going on in Astute Graphics, we'll put it in here as well. So you might be noticing a theme here. We're just trying to make it a lot easier for you to get the newest content, whatever is most important out there first. So be sure to come to the bottom and write us a review or just check out the existing ones. Now over here on the right, actually before I click on this guy, you might want to notice this as well. Monday to Friday, 10 a.m. to 5 p.m., but it's talking about GTM time. So Astute Graphics is based over in the UK. They're over in Herefordshire. So if you guys want to get a hold of them, just kind of keep in mind about the time difference in there. All right, so I'm going to click on this button right here to throw me all the way back up to the top. Now, a lot of the cool stuff for me is happening over here in the top because I could just find everything over here in the navigation. I mean, that's what it's all about, right? Clicking on shop is obviously going to take me to the software page, but in here you can find all kind of cool info about astutegraphics.com. And then over here on the right, we have this little slider bar here, this little section of buttons here, and it'll take you down to different sections of the website. But what I like to do is just hover over the shop link right here, and then I get access to all of these guys. Now, over on the left, we got the pro bundles. So that we're going to give you like a better deal on buying multiple tool sets at one time. So if you have some questions on those, just let me know in the chat. So for that, we have the Elite Bundle, Core, Draw, and Effects Bundles. Over here on the right, it says Plugins. Now in this column, this is where we're going to be able to target individual plugins at a time. So like today, we're going to be covering Phantasm and Collider Scribe. So if you want to know more info about those plugins, you would click on them right here, and it would take you directly to that info page. To the right of that, we decided to put all of the free stuff together because who doesn't like free stuff? Well, now we made it a lot easier for you guys to find this stuff. Try out Subscribe. Carlos, I'm sure you'll have some info to give us on that in a little bit. Once I finish up with the website thing, I'd love to hear some more about that. We're going to be talking about AutoSaviour Free in a little bit. And then here's the download sample artwork link again. All right, over here on the right, we have My Account. Now, that's something that's new for us. We didn't have this in the past, and I'm going to cover that more towards the end of the website section. All right, so over here we got support. Clicking on that is going to take you over to the support page. But what I like about it is, again, it's going to give you all the info you need. So here goes some artwork by DaCosta. And hovering over this support thing, I have access to my account. It's really important that you guys have access to that, so you're going to be able to find that scattered throughout the site. Frequently asked questions, we got them right here for you. Licensing information. Now, if you want to learn more about our tools, you could always go to the Astute Graphics YouTube channel. You're going to see a bunch of, I actually got a new series on there called the Vector Black Belt series. And you could also see some awesome videos by Alice Austin. She's our video content creator over in the UK. But if you were to click on this link right here, it's going to actually take you directly to another page that's going to show you some info on lynda.com. So if you're a member of lynda.com, you could also try it out. They have some great deals for new users as well. They have some courses by like Mike Rankin, Von Glitschka, and other awesome authors over at lynda.com. So click on this link to find out more info on that. Here's another way you guys can contact us. And if you want more info on the company itself, like maybe you want to know more about the individual team members, we got all that info for you right in here. The blog. Now, the blog was a big deal for us, because we get a lot of traffic going through our blog. We feel like we have a lot of really important information going on here, not only in just how to use our tools, but how to, you know, speed up your workflow when you're working in Adobe Illustrator. So this looks awesome, and it's going to look great on your phone as well. Now, over here at the top, we have the latest posts, tutorials, featured artists, or webinars. Now, each one is broken down into its own section. So again, we're just trying to make it easier for you guys to find everything. Now, if you're somewhere in the middle of this page, you could always just hover over blog, and you'll have access to all those links again. free trial is probably the first link I would go to if I've never heard of Astute Graphics before. I'd go straight to free trial. Now, the cool thing about this is you come down here, click on enter your email address, and then just submit it. After that, you'll get an email address. I mean, you'll get an email letting you know how to download the plugins installer, and that's going to start off your 14-day free trial on all the tools. Now, the great thing about this 14-day free trial is that you get full functionality with all the tools. So it's nothing, I mean, you could save your artwork. There's no watermarks. It's not like we're just going to give you access to half of the effects and tools. You have access to everything. That way you could try it out, see if you really like it, and then shoot us a little PayPal or come over here and empty out your cart, and then we'll send you a license key. All right, the other guy we have over here, this is going to give you direct access to the login for your account. Now, for those of you guys in the audience or watching the recording, if you already have purchased a license key from Astute Graphics and you don't know what this account thing is about, just come directly to this page, all right? What you want to do is click on this link here that says reset your password. Now, you're probably wondering what this is about. What happened is we created accounts for all of our existing customers. So if you have a license key, you got an account with this. Now, this account is going to be a quick way for you to access your purchasing history, your license keys, and the most current installer for your plugins. So it's just a direct access to all the things you need to stay in contact with your tools, all right? Now, if you're a new user, all you gotta do is get a license key and we'll automatically set up an account for you. All right, either way, once you get that login information, come right over here, enter in your username or email address, throw in that password, click login, and you're good to go. All right, just to the right of that, click on that. We're gonna get this little search field in here. So if you're looking for a particular term, like maybe free tools or something like that, you would just type that in right in here, and it would search throughout our site. I'll click on this to get rid of that. Don't forget, if you click on the link, I mean, on the link, on the logo, it'll take you right back to astutegraphics.com, the original page. All right, let's see. Last thing I wanted to mention, let me go back to a shop page. This was a really cool feature that I just noticed because, again, it's a brand new page. Check this out. Over at the top, it's showing me that this is 59 pounds. All right, well, if I go all the way to the bottom, down over here in the footer, check this out. I can switch over to dollar. And then when I come back to the top, now it shows me that VectorScribe is 92.58. So before, it was kind of hard to find out how much the products were going to cost. But now if you go down to the footer, just update that, and you'll have quick access to that information right there. So there you go, folks. Let's see Carlos and Miss Hannah, if we can get you guys back on. Throw your mics. And Carlos, I was curious to see what you would say about some of our free stuff over here. We got Subscribe.
Subscribe is one of the best tools that you have. And the best part is free. You can have access to yeah. Everybody wants a free stuff. I use a lot of time this tool because they provide me access to draw. For example, arc between two or three points, draw a circle between two or three points. Maybe you can show how to do that, Sebastian.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
But I love it. And I use every single day, and you can have access to important tools with this plugin. For example, to find the real center of the shape. Mm-hmm. I use a lot of times. I'm preparing some tutorial for the next couple of weeks, showing how to do some free stuff with nice. Subscribe.
Nice, cool, man, cool. Let's see. When I jump into the next demo, I'll do a quick shout out for the 3-point circle thing. And Hannah, we got anything going on over in the chat? Anything exciting? Any questions?
Okay, I'm just looking at the chat, and I actually mentioned that toward the end, we are going to offer a gift for the attendees. So one of them, we're going to raffle. I'm thinking about a creative way to raffle it since I don't have tickets. I have some new ideas since I spoke to you. Mm-hmm. So maybe more people will join in. Mm-hmm. And then toward the end, Sebastian, do you want to tell them what you're going to raffle?
Yeah, so the prize today, I checked with the Astute Graphics yesterday to see what they could give us. and they gave us a $55 voucher. So since we're showing off this AstuteGraphics.com, and one of the new features is our new a cart system, they decided to give us a voucher. So you guys are the first user group that I've worked with that is going to get a voucher. Now, the winner of this prize, all I'm going to need from you is your first name, last name, email address, and we can do that on a private chat. And then we will send you the voucher, and then you can go ahead, come over here to this little shop link, and any of these guys in here, mm-hmm. go ahead and apply that voucher to your purchase, and you're good to go. So thanks for mentioning that, Hannah, and if you could remind me in between the different demos, that'd be great too, in case, you know, some more people pop in. But how do you like the new site?
I love it. I think it's awesome. I think it's beautiful. It's creative. It's easy to do stuff, and it's really beautiful.
Yeah, it's really cool. I mean, the big thing is just being able to find stuff a lot easier. You know, I just it's fun to play with now. I like seeing how stuff grows in here and moves around.
Way better than before, and it's really wonderful.
Cool. All right, guys. So if there's nothing else, I'll jump into AutoSaviour next. All right, cool. So let me jump into that. Now, over here under Shop, right here we got this list of plugins, and we have AutoSaviour Pro. Now, clicking on this guy, let's see, down over here, I'm just going to switch over to US dollars. That's showing me that AutoSaviour Pro costs $39.23. Now, back over here under Shop, you might notice this. We have AutoSaviour, a free version. So let me switch over to this guy. Now, AutoSaviour Free is what we started off with. So we start off with AutoSaviour Free. We just thought, like, hey, there should be a tool that will automatically save and back up your artwork, and you could set up, you know, whatever time you need to. You have full control over that. So we created that. Our users ended up loving it. And they liked it so much that we started getting feedback and finding out new features that we should add to it. So we are listening to you guys. If there are some features or tools that you want, you know, let us know. Hit us up on social media or, you know, at the bottom of these pages. And you can contact us and let us know. Now, AutoSaviour Free is going to have some of the features. And then towards the end, I'll start showing you AutoSaviour Pro that has added features to it. So I'm going to jump over to Adobe Illustrator right now. Command N to open up a new document. And I'll name this guy AILA since they're our awesome host today. August meeting. All right, so there we go. Now, as soon as I click OK, check this out. AutoSaviour Pro jumps into action, and you're going to experience the same thing with AutoSaviour, the free version as well. Now, over here at the top, we have auto saving going on. I have enabled auto save or remind to happen every 10 minutes. Now, because I have this little button clicked right here, it's actually going to auto save every 10 minutes, but it's going to wait for 5 seconds after I make a change. Now, this was actually one of my favorite features, and I'd also be interested in Hannah and Carlos's feedback afterwards on how they use AutoSaviour. But for me, when I'm drawing with this, let's say if I click and drag and I start drawing something, 10 minutes pass. AutoSaviour wants to save this. Now, if it does a save, it might interrupt my workflow. Like, let's say I have a large document, raster effects, and all that stuff. But what AutoSaviour does in this mode is it's going to wait until I stop moving my cursor. It's going to wait for 5 seconds, and then it's going to do the autosave for me. And that's going to make sure that there's no interruption in my workflow. So when I'm talking about autosaving and automatically being saved and all that, I'm talking about this over here. Under File, you'll find Save. Well, AutoSaviour Pro is going to jump into the File menu, find Save, and click it for you every time. And it's going to do it every 10 minutes, every 5 minutes, every 45 minutes. Whatever you set it to, it'll go ahead and take care of that for you. Now, if you don't want it to save, because it is going to be overwriting your current document, it's just as if you were to be hitting Command S or Control S on a PC. Now, if you don't want that to happen, maybe you just want a little reminder. Click on this guy here, and now I've set it up to remind me every 10 minutes. So I'm going to switch this over to 1, just leave it like that. Now, if I click OK, it's going to go ahead and get started for me. Now, in order to find these settings again, if you're working with the free version or the paid version, you could always go into the File menu, scroll down until you find the AutoSaviour settings, click on that, and there you go. You got right back to the same guys. All right, so next we have backups. Backups are also included in the free version of AutoSaviour. So far, everything's been the same. You turn on the backups, but with the Pro version, the cool thing is not only can you save in the same folder as original, but with the Pro version, the paid version, You could actually pick a custom location. So if you click on browse, you could save this anywhere on your system or even a server somewhere else. Now, we're also going to give you access to having multiple versions. And because you could put as many versions as you want in here, it'd probably be a good idea to use it to append a suffix for them. In addition to that, you got sequential numbering just to keep everything super neat for you. And it's all done automatically. You don't even have to add a suffix if you don't want to. But check this out. Currently, the way it's going to lay this out is it's going to show me that it'll have the file name, hyphen, and then 001. All right, if I come in here and add my best friend's name right in there, now it says Hannah, it says the file name, it'll add Hannah slash 001 to the end of it. Now, let's say you want to switch that up. We could switch over to timestamp, and we have all these different formats that you could use. All right. So let me turn, I'm gonna turn this guy off for now. I'm gonna click OK. And what I should do next is just make a quick edit to this. There we go. Now go back into the settings so we can start talking about this big button over here at the bottom. This is gonna edit the settings for new documents, all right? So it's new documents and also documents that AutoSaviour Pro has not previously encountered. So like if Carlos were to send me a document that that he didn't use AutoSaviour Pro on, then these are the settings. Basically, think of this as your default settings for every time you have a new document, all right? By default, we have it set to immediately ask for AutoSaviour Pro settings. You could also click on this button over here at the top and switch it up to just apply these settings. Now, these are the same settings we talked about earlier. So if you want all of your new documents to automatically save every 10 minutes, but it'll wait for 5 seconds after you make a change, and you want it to have a backup in a specific location, and you want to, I don't know, limit it to 7 copies, and you could do this to all your documents just by having it set right here in the AutoSaviour Pro new document settings. One thing I did want to mention right here, it says keep. It also says when the specified number of backups is exceeded, the oldest backup file will be deleted. I just wanted to show that off because I'm sure you guys didn't know that our developers were poets. All right, so I'm going to get rid of this real quick in here. I'm going to tell it to ask for settings, but after about 45 minutes. That's how I work with it. The reason I like to do that is sometimes I might just have a quick idea, right? And I really don't want it to save anything for me or ask me about the settings. But after about 45 minutes, I'm going to have a pretty good indication that whether or not I want to save this file or not. You know what I mean? So after 45 minutes, the AutoSaviour Pro document settings will jump out at me, and then I can decide whether or not I want to save and back up that guy. I'll click OK. Leave this guy alone. Click OK. Now check this out. Because more than a minute has passed, and look, over here on the top, see this little asterisk? That's telling me that this file has not been saved. So I get this little friendly reminder here. It says AutoSaviour Pro friendly reminder. It's time to save your work. So I click OK, and that's fine. It just continues on. It's just a reminder letting me know it's on there. Another way, another function for that is that I'll have it go off every hour so that I know how to, how to bill my client or keep track of a specified time. Like, let's say Carlos told me he's only going to pay me for 3 hours of work. Well, I'm going to tell AutoSaviour Pro to remind me like every hour or maybe every 3 hours, whatever works for you. And that way I'll know to stop working and then send the file over to him. All right, now AutoSaviour Pro, when we're working with that, you could go into the window menu. Now this is specific for AutoSaviour Pro. You click on this AutoSaviour Pro panel and look, it's angry at me because I don't have a save going on here. Down here at the bottom, it's going to give you quick access to your AutoSaviour Pro settings. Now I want to tell it to autosave for me. I'll click OK. The reason I wanted to do that was I wanted this window to come up. Now, this window will come up if you have not saved this document before. Notice right here it says save as. It's because I haven't saved this before. Remember, you and I opened it. It's a brand new document. So another thing I want to mention is in the AutoSaviour Pro version, we give you this little watermark back here. So the reason that watermark is important is we want you guys to know what's actually happening. Because if you have a large document and it saves happening, there's a good chance you might think your computer froze because you didn't hit Command S. It just happened. It's because it's automatically saving for you. So what we did is we threw this little watermark here to let you know if there's a save going on. All right, so I'll click save on there and click OK. There we go. Look, it's nice and happy. Everything's zeroed out. Shows me that the document is unmodified. I'm going to modify this guy one more time. Now it's starting to count things down for me. So over here, it shows me that the last save happened about 5 seconds ago. Over here on the right side of the panel, it says that the next save is going to happen in about 49 seconds. Shows me that there's an auto save pending. So I got full status of what's going on with my document right here. Now over here, we're giving you quick access to some frequently used features. So it shows me that I have the auto save or the remind feature turned on. I could quickly turn on or off this backup feature just by turning on this little X here. Now if I click on settings, boom, takes me right back to the document settings, which you're already familiar with. Over here in the upper right, we got these two little kind of almost hidden buttons. Click on this little drop down menu and you could change how the panel looks. So that's going to make it more compact. So if you only want to see these little counters, you got access to that. Let's expand it so I could see the whole thing. And down over here says the AutoSaviour Pro preferences. Now the cool thing about these preferences is it's going to be different for everybody's workflow. So right here, it shows message during save and backup. That's that watermark I was talking about earlier. I always have this thing turned on. Now this feature only auto save the active document. Sometimes I have it on, sometimes I have it off. What that means is if I have several tabs going on here, if I turn this feature on, it's only going to auto save that one that I have activated. The rest of them that are not activated or deactivated, those guys will be ignored. So I'm just going to go ahead and leave this guy on. So now it's going to auto save everything. No matter what I got open, it's going to auto save it. So now let's see what happens when I click OK. All right, it just saved everything for me. You notice that? It happened really fast because that minute had already passed since my last save. So I didn't have to do anything. AutoSaviour Pro just took care of it for me. Looks like it's asleep right now because I haven't made a change, but as soon as I make a change, boom, it's back in action. All right, so let me just make some quick changes to this so it doesn't mess up my demo later. There you go, click OK for that. So Hannah, Carlos, that's what I got for AutoSaviour Pro. And the free version. I wanted to see, get some feedback from you guys. And Carlos, if you want to show anything on your screen, let me know.
So far, so good. I use it. Some people, I don't know, some people for their workflow, I mean, maybe in the chat they can answer us if they can use it or not.
Cool. Yeah, that's always a good one to know. Like, is this a feature that you guys dig? You know, something that... we'll just go ahead and automatically save your work for you and back it up for you.
I use every day, especially when you are working on the critical documents.
Yeah,
it's important to turn on the backup system. I love it, and I save my Mac a lot of times.
Definitely.
Especially with complex documents. Let me show this document right here. Where I can share my screen.
There you go. Let me. I'm about to throw it over your way right now. I'm gonna make you presenter. Okay.
Just a quick.
There you go.
Let me know when you can see my screen.
You got it, boss. Let's see. It should be warming up. There we go. Now I can see your screen. Go for it, bro.
Oh, this is cool.
Okay, this is one of the biggest. And complex works that I make with especially with Collider. This is for the demo for Collider Scribe 2.
It looks beautiful.
And this is a very complex document. As you can see, they have huge, huge work. Every piece is put by hand using the Collider Scribe. So I need to save every 5 minutes because of the crash, especially if you are testing a new plugin. So this is my feature for this. Yeah, this is my feature for this document. As you can see, I enable the auto save for every 10 minutes and a backup for the 5 previous versions. This feature save this word a lot of time because in this particular case, I'm testing the new Collider Scribe in the beta status. So sometimes, of course, the plugin crashed. So AutoSaviour save my back in this particular project, and I love it. And I recommend for even the free version, people love it.
Yeah, definitely.
For sure.
Yeah, I would say try out the free version first, and if you find it useful, go ahead and get that license key for the pro version. Cool,
okay,
man.
Teresa.
Let me see.
Teresa, I have a question here. Let me. Okay. Teresa said, seeing the countdown give me an idea for another Astute plugin, a counter per document for freelancers. So you can propose that to Nick.
Yeah, yeah. Which one was it again? Sorry. Right. What was it?
It's Teresa.
What did it say?
Teresa. What did it say? Counter per document for freelancers.
There you go.
You
yeah.
know, like a time time tracker.
Definitely. Definitely.
All right. That's great. Right. Right. Good idea.
Yeah. Good idea. Right.
All
right.
Cool. I got this one written down. And plus, just so you guys know, the folks over in the office and the owner of the company do watch these videos. So all your feedback is definitely going to be heard and appreciated. All right. Let's see. So we went over AutoSaviour Pro, we went over the website. Do you guys have any other questions, anything at all in the chat going on about AutoSaviour, or should I go ahead to Phantasm next?
Maybe go ahead to Phantasm now.
Cool.
And then we'll see if there's more questions.
You got it. Thanks. And then if there's any new folks in the webinar right now, don't forget we have a prize at the end. We're going to be giving away a $55 voucher for Astute Graphics products. All right, cool. You know what I just realized? I forgot to talk about something that Carlos mentioned earlier. If you take a look over on my tools panel on the left, I got this tool set right here. Now, this is going to look different from yours. Right here, I have circles by 2 or 3 points, line tangent to 2 paths, orient, and connect. These 4 stacks is what Subscribe is. So this is a free tool, and when you click on one of these guys, notice we have all these different tools in here as well. So we're making it a lot easier for you guys to make circles and arcs more intuitively in here, and then also being able to create these lines in here. So you have tangent to 2 paths, line perpendicular to 2 paths, line tangent to path, and it just continues on that way. So this is all the really techie stuff that sometimes it's a little bit harder to do in Illustrator just straight away. And we're just giving you guides and like awesome snaps to help you out with that stuff. So for example, like if you click, come over here, check that out. I got this circle growing over here. And when I click again, I have this, it's already finished off for me. It looks great. It'll help you out when you're building stuff, technical artwork and stuff like that. It's really going to help you out. Carlos has a blast with it. And you already saw how technical his stuff can get. All right, so I want to jump into Phantasm next. Phantasm is one that always gets a lot of oohs and ahs from folks. So what we're trying to do is bring in a lot of your functionality that you have in Photoshop. Yeah, that's right, Photoshop, into Adobe Illustrator. So let me open up a couple documents really quick. Command-O to open this up. I got the AILA August meeting, Phantasm, and I'll grab these two dudes right here. Now, if you've seen me demo these before, some of these images might look familiar, but I figured I'd show them a little bit differently than I have in the past. Now, one thing I want to mention, since this is an Adobe Illustrator user group, if you guys are afraid of the gradient mesh, you are not alone. I was as well. And around somewhere week 65 of my Never Stop Learning project, I decided to check out the gradient mesh tool. Now, this guy over here on the left is my first attempt. The green apple is my second attempt. Notice I tried to play with the apple that had less detail this time. I got a little intimidated. And then I went with the eggplant, and the eggplant gave me the courage to go back to the original apple, and this is what I ended up with my fourth attempt. So for you folks that are intimidated by the gradient mesh, this is one night's worth of work right here. If you just stick to it, practice it over and over again, you will see the progression right away, I promise. All right, so let me get back out of here really quick and just focus in on this guy. Now, I love using this because, check this out, this is created with all these different points. Now, there are a couple different ways to recolor this guy. One of them, unfortunately, is recoloring each one of these points, because if you notice, take a look over here in the bottom left section of my screen, it's showing me that the fill has this like really light pink color. It's almost white, but it's kind of pink. And if I switch over to another one of these points, it's a darker red, and it just kind of continues on that way. So I don't want to sit there and color every single one of those. I can create a new shape over it and maybe turn this one to black and white and then color that other shape some different colors until I get the right color combination with the blend modes and all that. But honestly, a lot of times most people will export this, take it into Photoshop, and then colorize it in there. But then you lose all the vector stuff, and that's what's great about working with vectors. You know, you don't have to worry about pixels and stuff where we could scale whatever we want. So in comes in Phantasm. Now, I've downloaded and installed Phantasm on this machine, If you don't have it, you can go over to astutegraphics.com, you know, that awesome website we were looking at earlier, and you could download it and try it out for free for 14 days. Now, you can find this guy by coming over here to the effect menu at the top of the screen. Scroll down till you find Phantasm, and then over here, check this out. You have access to all these awesome effects here. So they're all the ones like you're used to seeing in Photoshop. We got brightness, contrast, curves, desaturate, duotone, exposure, halftone, hue saturation, invert, levels, shift to color, and temperature tint. So all those guys sound familiar, and they work the exact same way. The one I want to play around with first is going to be hue saturation. All right, so I click on this guy. Now, you can play around with these sliders however you want, but I like to just click on colorize. First thing you want to do is bring up the saturation, because look, it was kind of dull there, right? Notice this, as I, now it's like a candy apple. Looks awesome. Now the hue, as I click and drag, you'll see the color change over on the bottom. And once I release, you see it's going to be updated over here. Now when I'm saying the bottom, I mean this guy right over here, just above the options. See, it's kind of golden here. So it's going to be this color with saturation and lightness applied to it to equal this. So as I come over here, slide it over. Let's see, I want like a lime greenish apple. There we go, like a Jolly Rancher looking apple. Let me see, maybe something more in the bluish or teal. There we go. Now we're starting to get more in the blue range. So whatever your client wants, you got them covered right here. So quick way to work with this, we switched over from a red apple to, let's switch it over to a green apple, something like that. That looks cool. I'll click OK. That looks fantastic. I really enjoy how this looks. You can send it off to your client, and they'd be happy with that. Now I'm going to target this guy, and I'm going to bring up my appearance panel over in the upper right section. Now, for those of you guys that don't use your appearance panel, please, please try to check it out. There's a lot of power in your appearance panel, okay? Right here, it's showing us that we have the Phantasm Hue Saturation Live Effect already applied in here. We could continue to pile on more live effects in there. Right here at the bottom, you got this little guy that's going to add a new effect. Come down to Phantasm. Now, I want to get more contrast in here, so I'm going to click on Levels. And it's the same levels you're used to working with in Photoshop. One thing I forgot to mention with the hue saturation one that is also true for levels, check this out over on the right. You could load and save off settings, right? So you can use them on future Phantasm projects, but you could also load and save off the settings from Photoshop. So if you have a histogram in your junk drive from Photoshop that you love to apply to different artwork, you could always load it up in Phantasm right in here. Or let's say you create an awesome histogram in Phantasm over here in Adobe Illustrator, save that dude off and switch it over to Photoshop, and you'll have the exact same histogram in there. All right, so I want to bring in a little bit of this white, not too much because it's already bright enough. I do want to bring in this dark point so we could have a lot more drama going on in here. Plus, you guys are online. I want to make sure you guys can really see this stuff. All the fun happens with the midtones. All right, so I'll bring it over towards the right just to get more contrast. There you go. Now it's almost like a jewel of an apple right here. All right, I probably wouldn't go with it on a real project, but I kind of like how it looks right now, so I'm going to leave it alone. Let's see. So that looks great. I like how this is. If I select it in the appearance panel, it shows me the live effects. Now, I could continue to add effects in here, but one thing I want to bring up is our clients always change their minds, right? So if your client sees this and says, you know what, I don't want a green apple, I want a blue apple. Blue apples are what's in right now. Then you come back to the appearance panel. Click right here which says hue saturation. And it's going to bring up that exact same effect. So it's not a new effect. It's the one you already had applied in there. All right, so let's switch over to, what did I say earlier? Blue apple, I think. All right, so let me find a blue. I think I said blue. All right, somewhere around here, nice dark blue. Actually, I like that a lot. It looks like a cue ball blue. I like that. All right, so there we go. We got it updated. Now I have this awesome one. I could, you know, go ahead and bill my client for all that time. And honestly, in that type of job, I already made up my money back from purchasing Phantasm. Just that quick. All right, we have a lot of other effects going on in here. I'm going to get rid of this hue saturation one for now. But I'm going to leave that Phantasm levels one in there because it just looks fantastic. I like it. All right, so I got this guy selected in the appearance panel. I want to show you guys this dude over here. Halftone. All right, so we can continue on with the different effects, but this halftone one is really special. For me, it's a little bit challenging, or at least not as fun to create halftone effects in Illustrator native. So when I heard of Phantasm, I just went bananas for it. So what we're doing over here is checking out this DPI. Current, by default, it's set to 18, but I could drop that. And when I reduce the DPI, it's actually going to increase the size of those dots for me. So hopefully this is translating well for you guys online. Let me go ahead, maybe around 5 right now. Looks good. Now, over here on the top says different types that we could use. We could sample the original artwork. That looks great. Or let's see, when I had it on monochrome, notice we have this little color chip. You click on that, and you can pick whatever color you want. So I already know Carlos's favorite color is blue, so I'll go with blue again. And then we got this blue halftone set up here. So let me switch over to, I like the sampled one. I still liked how this looked. Because of all that contrast, notice we're starting to get some really cool halftoning going on in there. All right, this looks great. You can make all kinds of changes. You could also add an undercoat there. Now, this isn't going to look as cool for this one, but I still want to bring it up anyway. Let me see, maybe a yellow background. Click OK. Oh, yeah, it didn't work too bad. I was worried it was going to be kind of harsh, but it looks great right there. If you want to see what it looks like without it, just uncheck that little box. There you go. That looks pretty cool. Now, let me come down over here. We have the dot properties. By default, it's set to circle. That's probably the one that looks the best, but we're going to give you some more options. You could do squares, so it looks a little bit more digital right there. Lines. The lines kind of end up looking a little bit more like pills. Characters. So now it has all these cool letters. I really enjoy this one. I use this a lot, actually. If you guys saw my Photoshop webinar 2 weeks ago, this is how I did the banner for it. Now, if you go into the options, you could switch whatever font you want. You could repeat the text. Now, so I'm coming here. You know I'm going to keep putting in Hana's name right here. So I click OK. Boop. Now it just says Hana over and over and over again for this halftone. It's a Hana halftone. I like that. All right, so this last one over here, selected symbol. This one's awesome too. I don't really use it as much as I should, but I'm going to create a video on it pretty soon, so maybe I'll use it more soon. Selected symbol. If you guys are familiar with symbols, all you have to do is create a symbol. Before you come into Phantasm, make sure it's selected in your panel, and then you could use that selected symbol as your halftone in here. So think of branding or just think of creative artistic look. I'm going to go back to circles. And let's see, what else could we do in here? Oh, this grid angle. I like switching this over to about 30 degrees. Most of the time, I'll switch it to 30. It just looks cool. I like it how it's staggered this way. Let me see. Tension heights, bend. No, I wanted to change. Oh, the origin. No, not the origin. Pattern. Instead of grid, I wanted to go with radial because this is one I don't really get to show off too much. So I know Rosie's seen this demo before, but I don't think I've shown you guys this part. So maybe she'll like this. All right, I set it over to a radial halftone and notice that it's all radiating from the dead center of my object. Well, over here we have this little 9-block grid and we could do it from the bottom left, upper right, whatever you want. But what I want to do is add in a specific value. So here in the X coordinate, I'm gonna just move this guy over a little bit towards the right. So about 60 looks good. Under, over here for Y, I'm gonna go up to, I don't know, let's see, 250? Yeah, 250 looks good. Now it looks like the whole halftone is radiating out of this little highlight right here. So that's a pretty cool way to work with it right there. I like it. Look, even these little dots down here in the bottom, they're black. This is a really sweet halftone. And if you want to continue to edit it, over here in the dot gain, check this out. You can make a more sophisticated curve in here. So right there, I'm making the change a little bit more dramatic. I'm going to bring it over here this way. Now we're going to deal with fat guys. This is a nice little fat halftone dots in here. All right, so down this way, it's going to have them a little bit more subtle, but look, it's going to have a more dramatic change. I'll go back up this way. Sorry, I just have fun playing around with that. Cool thing is you could always save off your settings and then use them again on a different project later on. All right, so I'll click OK. Deselect this guy. Now, one thing I want to mention about this, my boss always wants me to say this, is these circles are 100% vector. So I'm zooming in all the way as much as I can. And notice now I zoomed in 64,000%. And it looks awesome. I love how it looks. All right, so I'll zoom all the way back out. Oops. There we go. And
can I ask a question?
Yeah, what's up? What you got? Oh.
Okay, well, Olivia, she's asking, Elvia, she's asking here, she got a license for, I think, CS2, and can she get a free upgrade? Also, she's asking if this license is for Group of Designer, because, you know, she's ahead of a whole department and I wonder if she can get some ideas about doing it for a group.
Yeah. For group stuff, I would definitely shoot us an email over at astutegraphics.com. You know how I showed you a couple of those little pages to contact us? Use those. Or Hannah, if you don't mind writing in the link, what was it? I think it's inquiries at astutegraphics.com.
Yeah, I'm trying to do it and it doesn't show up with my answers. I don't know why.
I send the email to Elvia
Okay, great.
Okay,
with this
good.
particular address.
Yeah, that'd be
Okay.
great. Cool. And then
Yeah,
for the upgrade thing, hopefully you win the voucher, and then that way you'd be able to upgrade it that way. Let's see.
because I think you need to upgrade that from the new version, for example, for Collider Scribe, Vector Scribe to the new things, stylism
Yep. So
setting.
for a lot of those, if they have new functionality, like it's the new version of it, then if you want to upgrade, they are going to be a charge for that. So just keep an eye out for that. Actually, too, I don't know if I'm supposed to be mentioning this, but we're going to be having a sale coming up soon, so keep an eye out on our website for that. but definitely just shoot us an email and we'll get right back to you on that one. As far as the upgrade goes, yeah, there's a little bit of a charge on there, but who knows, you might win the voucher tonight and that should take care of it for you.
Yeah, I wanted to show Sebastian. I don't know if you show, but I have like actually a sample of something that I used for Phantasm.
Yeah. You want me to
You want me to
make your
show
presenter
it?
really
I
quick?
can.
All right, here we
Yes.
go.
I don't know how to do it.
I'm doing it. I got it.
Okay.
All right, so I threw it your way, and I'll let you know as soon as I can see your screen. All right, here
You
we go.
see my
Now,
screen now?
there it is. Who's that,
Okay,
Romy?
so this is something I just did, and I actually added a opacity mask for it too in the end. But the
Cool.
idea was I wrote some stuff. It's my two girls,
Nice.
and I just worked with it just to create something fun, and then end up writing love and all kind of sayings in there. If I zoom into it, you'll see there's some stuff there. But like I wrote some stuff, so I
Oh,
kind
that's
of like
cool
had
because
some.
from far it looks like cross stitch kind of.
Yeah, but you see, I wrote on Gillies. I wrote her like love, 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 love. It was just before, her wedding, and I wanted to make something fun. And then you can see some of the highlights and everything. I just worked with opacity mask and Illustrator with
Nice.
gradients and everything. So the base was a regular picture, and then it went into, and it's kind of all, if you zoom in, you can see it's all vector.
Cool.
You can,
Oh,
so that's kind of cool. Anyway, this is what I wanted to add. That's it.
that's awesome. So I'll take the screen away from
Awesome.
you.
Great.
One thing I wanted to
Take it
mention
away. Take
about
it away.
that too is that if she decided she wanted to change the text later, it's live, so she could definitely do that really easy. Just going
Yep.
back into the live effect and take care of it there.
Yeah. Awesome. Yeah, exactly.
Let's see. Really quick, last thing I wanted to show you guys about Phantasm, and then I'll jump in again and ask you guys any questions. There's another effect in here, a duotone effect. This is some artwork not created by me. This is actually created by this guy over here, Mr. Sean Ferguson, right over here. Let me put his info on the screen there so you guys can take a screenshot if you want to find more info on him. All right, so this was when Stylism came out. It's a plugin by Astute Graphics that allows you to work with the native live effects more easily and more intuitively. Now, what I'm going to use it for is I wanted to leave this one last because this is really RAM intensive in here. There's a lot of effects going on, and it's a large document, bunch of anchor points, all that fun stuff. But I'm going to select this guy over here. All right, I'll move it over a little bit. Under the Effect menu, Phantasm, and I want to bring up this guy over here, Duotone. All right, so right away it applies this orange here as a duotone, orange for Astute Graphics. But check this out, you also have this curve graph here you can play around with. I'm just going to target the midtones. If I drag it downwards, let's see what happens. What I notice is that it ends up doing kind of like the opposite of what I would expect in Photoshop. So this is the only place that our curves graph is going to be a little bit different than you're used to working. So here it lightened things up. So if I click and drag, oops, it looks like I mixed it. I'm going to bring this dude upwards. And then that's when we're going to start getting a little bit more of that contrasty look in there that I wanted. All right, so along with orange, let me switch over to a different color and go with blue. For some reason, I keep picking blue today. All right, and because it's a large document, it takes a sec, but there it is. Here's what I really wanted to show you guys. In this curves graph, even though it is a little funky, but check this out. you have this line represented in blue, so you know exactly which one it is that you're targeting. So if you have this guy right here, I could click and drag downwards, and then it's going to take a couple seconds to go ahead and update. Boom, there it is. Now it's showing off some more of that orange. Now if I click and drag and bring this guy upwards, it's going to introduce some more of that blue in there. So I kind of look at it that way when I'm working with this curve. If I want more of that ink, I'll bring it up. If I want less of that ink, I'll bring it down. So just keep an eye on that. But it's a great way for you to come in here and quickly reduce the colors that you need in here. And you could always fine tune stuff. Don't forget, you could save and load new ones. But now that I have this one in here, why not go into Phantasm, let's say like levels or something like that, and just continue to edit the same way you would in Photoshop. I'm looking at the appearance panel the same way that I would look at the layers panel with all my adjustment layers and stuff like that. So here we go. Goes ahead and updates. I'll make a change to the midtones a little bit. There you go, lightens things up for me. So I kind of like this little faint look. It almost makes me think of colors that I would use for like some publishing for a school book or something like that. Let's say like a newsletter or something. And when I come back more towards the right, you see it's going to bring back some of that color. It's going to have more punch. It just has more contrast. So we're giving you full freedom in here. You no longer have to export these beautiful vectors and turn them into pixels and hoping that they don't get pixelated. So we're protecting everything for you, keeping it all here in vector, bringing in Photoshop, colorizing stuff into Adobe Illustrator. All right, so Carlos, Hanna, that's what I got for Phantasm. You guys got anything to
okay,
add to
I
that?
Think we're
or
running out of time. Yes. Yeah, oh, yeah. I think. It's okay. Do you have anything else you wanted to show
yeah,
today?
Yeah. I got Collider Scribe. Yeah, I'll just do it really fast just so you get an idea of what it does.
Okay.
All right. So okay. I'm not going to go in right. deep with it because it looks like we got like 8 minutes and we still have to do the voucher giveaway. So right here, what I got is I'm going to grab this guy under the window menu, Collider Scribe, space fill panel. All right, let me just release this guy really quick. So what I have here on the left is a larger object than this guy over here on the right. The large object is my container, and I'm going to fill it in with this little star. Select both of them, click on Make, and check it out. It just randomly starts filling this in here. You have all the controls in here. The uniformity is currently set to none. But let me see. I'm going to start adding a couple more pieces in here. Now we have multiple copies. Now, I don't have to vary the size, maybe the rotation. Now what I'm going to do is just try to make things a little bit more uniform. And now it's just starting to fill in that artwork right in there as best as it can, nice and uniform. All right. So if I switch over to something like this, just to show you guys a little bit more practical use, this large piece is my container, and these three shapes over here are going to be my fill objects. So when I click on Make, check that out. I have this uniform pattern in here, but like we did earlier, we could vary the size. And check this out. Every time I hit randomize, it's going to give me a completely different look, and it's just filling in that area. So there's a couple different workflows for this. The last one I'll show you is over here. The reason why I wanted to show you this one is it's great how our plugins work in with native features of Adobe Illustrator. So this is an ice cube. And look, check this out. Everywhere it moves, we have this transform live effect applied to it over here. Oops, let me get out of that. We have a transform live effect applied to it over here in the appearance panel. So when I grab this guy and move it, oops, I didn't mean to double click. When I move it, that little transformation is happening in real time. So I'm going to select these dudes, click on Make, and there you go. Now I got way too much stuff going on in here. Let me bring this down to, instead of 14 copies, maybe just 4 ice cubes. And I don't want to vary the size just yet, or maybe not that much. Anyway, you can play around with this as much as you need to. I do want to vary the rotation. There we go. Look, that's already starting to look awesome. Vary the size, but maybe not by that much. Let me bring it down. Let's see, down to 2, maybe 1. There we go. That looks cool. Because I know Carlos doesn't like a lot of ice in his whiskey, so I'll just leave it something like that. And notice, I still have the reflection right here. So even though we're applying this space fill effect to it, it's still honoring the native live effect in Adobe Illustrator, which is just a transform reflection going on in there. So there you go, folks. That's all the plugins that I wanted to go over
this
with you guys
cool.
today.
Amazing.